What is the definition of white nationalism? Some people think that white nationalism is the superior of the white race in the United States. Is that really what it means? See, here's a problem. I think too many people get white nationalism mixed up with white supremacy. Because I admit I'm a nationalist and I'm white. Does that make me a white nationalist? I'm not a racist. I'm not. I don't discriminate freedom of religion. Freedom of religion is a constitutional right. I really don't care if you're an atheist, a Christian. I prefer a Christian because I'm a Christian. I accepted my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But when it comes to religion, I don't care if you're a Buddhist, a Hindu, a Jew, a Christian, an atheist, a Jehovah's Witness, a Mormon, a Muslim. I know it's a lot of, I know the Muslim thing is a touchy subject with conservatives. But me, I don't care if you're Muslim. That doesn't bother me. I don't discriminate against Muslims, just like I don't discriminate against Jews, Hindus, Buddhists. Just like I don't discriminate with anybody with a certain skin color. You can't help what you're born. Freedom of religion is a constitutional right. A lot of conservatives out there see Muslims as, well, I'm not going to discriminate against Muslims. Freedom of religion is a constitutional right. When we talk about white nationalism, a lot of the liberal left think that white nationalism is a problem. When in fact, white nationalism is a white person that supports nationalist views. Nationalism is putting your country first before the rest of the world. What does it say in the Bible? It says in the Bible to help yourself before you can help others. Because if you can't help yourself, how are you going to help others? You can't be in a position to help others if you can't help yourself. That's why God says help yourself before you can help others. It also says in the Bible to give. And do give. I do give. I give to Children's Hospital. Every time I eat at Panda Express, I've done some other things. I give. I give back. I really do. I give my time. I do charitable things that you don't hear about or see about on YouTube because I have a life outside of YouTube. And I don't care to post it. Because I don't want to be... Because I just don't take recognition for it because... I just don't. I just, you know, I do charitable things. It says in the Bible to give. But you got to be in a position to help yourself before you can help others. Well, that's sort of like nationalism. Where you support your country before you support the rest of the world. That's what nationalism is. And being that I'm white, does that make me a white nationalist? But the liberal left seem to think that white nationalism is associated with white supremacy. Two different things. White supremacy is the superior of the white race. They think that the white race is superior. I don't think that way. There's only one race that is superior, and that's the human race. So, let me be clear. I am not a white supremacist. I am, however, a white nationalist. Okay? And I do support the Confederate flag because I got Southern heritage. It goes back to Confederacies. I had ancestors that fought on the Confederate side of the Civil War. So being that I just said I'm a white nationalist and I support the Confederate flag, that would be a double whammy with the liberal left thinking that I'm a racist when I'm not. But you gotta be careful because people get offended easily over nothing, over a damn... You get offended over a damn flag. Now, am I offended by the gay flag? It's kind of offensive to my Christianity because God created the rainbow. And the rainbow was something that God created. And then the gays, they took it and made it queer for their queer agenda. So am I offended by the gay flag? Yes, but I don't let it offend me. Just like the Confederate flag. Maybe you are offended by it, but you shouldn't have let it offend you. It's a piece of cloth. I got better things in life to worry about and more important things to worry about than a neighbor across the street waving a gay flag. I don't care. It's his damn flag. He can wave it if he wants. There was a guy in the news that was waving a swastika flag. Now, I don't support the swastika. No. I don't support Nazi Germany. I don't support Hitler. But if somebody wants to wave their swastika flag, I say go for it. freedom of speech, freedom to, you know, freedom of assembly was a constitutional right. I'm not going to say I support the swastika Nazi flag. I'm not going to say I support the gay flag. But if somebody wants to wave those flags, they have absolute constitutional right to do so under the First Amendment, freedom of speech, freedom to assemble, freedom to express yourself. Okay, so I want to clarify the difference between white nationalism and white supremacy. I'm not a white supremacist. A white supremacist is they believe that the white race is superior to all the races, and they want to make this country white. First off, this country was never fully white. The white people dominated during the Native American days when we, you know, made them almost extinct to put them on reservations. I'm not proud of that, and that wasn't really a lot of the white people that did that. That was the pilgrims that did that. Christopher Columbus wasn't responsible for the execution of the Native Americans. That was the pilgrims. My ancestors, the Scottish, and the German ancestry that I have, which I did some research, some of my German ancestry did flee to Israel during the 1947 occupation, during distant cousins of mine that I have in Israel, so I do have some Israeli connections. My brother will sit up here and deny it all he wants, but I found a link on Ancestry.com. But anyway, what was I at? I got sidetracked. Like I said, I don't really... My ancestors had nothing to do with the execution of the Native Americans. I'm not going to support something like that, a genocide of an entire race. Absolutely not. The pilgrims are nasty fucking people. But blame it on Christopher Columbus is insane. Christopher Columbus sailed the ocean blue 1492. The pilgrims didn't come to 1620. During the first Thanksgiving festival, when the Native Americans sat down with the pilgrims, they had dinner. And after that, that's when this started. Okay? Yeah, I support the Second Amendment. Damn right. You know, the Pope says a real Christian doesn't carry guns. You know what? Fuck the Pope. Because it says in the Bible that if you cannot afford a sword, you shall sell your cloth and buy one. And it also says eye for an eye and tooth for a tooth. So like I said, again, I don't answer to the Pope. The Pope is a hypocrite. I'm a Christian. My father is Jesus Christ, not the Pope. So fuck the Pope. Fuck the Pope. Are you offended yet? Sieg Heil, motherfucker. How about that? Like I said, I just said that to offend somebody because, oh, it's offensive. No. Like I said, there's a difference between white nationalism and white supremacy. Okay? And this is white supremacy. That's not who I am. I support my country before I support the whole entire world. We need to take care of our own first before we can help the other rest of the world. Okay, that's fine. But like I said, this nation was never a white race nation, and it never will be. I'm all about diversity. This nation was founded on immigration, which is fine. I'm all about legal immigration. We need to watch what we're bringing here. You know, we're not going to have a country. So, and for all you people saying that, well, the white people invaded the USA and took the land from the Native Americans. Let me explain something to you. When Christopher Columbus sailed the ocean blue, he was looking to cross the entire world. He thought he landed back in India. That's why he called them people the Indians, the Native Americans. The original Native Americans, the ones I heard that dominated this country before we did, they don't like the name Indian. Native American is the proper word. it's Indian is offensive to them. All right, I'm out.